Hey everyone, this video is a general overview crash course about the different genres of EDM, all the types of music you're gonna hear at raves and EDM festivals, and I will play song examples so you can hear what they sound like. If you're new to my channel, hello, my name is Cotton Candy. I am an EDM and music festival junkie, so I travel the world going to different events to make exclusive video content about them. Huge disclaimer, I am not an expert on any EDM genre. I am not a producer, I am not a DJ. I've just been listening to dance music and raving and going to festivals for a very, very, very long time. This is just a beginner's guide to EDM, and it was so incredibly difficult to like lump all of these different subgenres into digestible categories of these main genres, because there are so many and they're just so different. It's not necessarily fair to be grouping them together. But again, this is a beginner's guide, an introduction to the genres of EDM. The first genre on my list is house music. House music is all about the rhythm and the beat. It less has to do with like big drops, which a lot of genres of EDM do. And there are so many different genres and subgenres that are technically house music. There's actually like big room house, electro house, tech house, progressive house, deep house, tribal house, like the different styles literally goes on and on. Here are a few song examples of the different types of house music, just so you can get an idea of what they generally sound like and see that there are so many types of subgenres and styles that they hardly fit under this one category of house. Producer DJs like to mix and match the different styles, and so it's really hard to pinpoint exactly what genre a song is, but these were some examples so you can get like a general idea of house music. Here is a list of different house music DJs that you can check out. Carl Cox, Fisher, Chris Lake, Mala and Chami, Dombrowski, Dr. Fresh is so good. He has such a unique style. Jamie Jones and Hot Since 82. Here are a couple house podcasts I would recommend checking out. Michael Calfon's Treasured Tape, Toll Room Radio by Mark Knight. And then also, like, you can look up house DJs and listen to their music, but I think the best way to get a feel for the actual music is to watch or listen to those DJs' live sets on YouTube, SoundCloud, MixCloud, and they're fun. Like the Tomorrowland Music Festival live sets, the Ultra Music Festival live sets. They have DJ sets from all the different genres and they're super fun to watch. So I pulled Big Room House aside because I definitely think it needs to be separated from all the other genres of house music. Big Room House can for the most part be a lot more commercial, mainstream. Examples of producer DJs who mostly do like Big Room would be like Martin Garrix, Tiesto, Hardwell, W&W, Afrojack, Nicky Romero, the list goes on and on, but you get the picture. Basically all the huge main acts that you're gonna see on the main stage of these really big festivals. I'm not gonna play any examples of Big Room because all of these DJs are so big that playing their music in this video will definitely get my video deleted. All of these DJs especially do have their live sets on like YouTube and SoundCloud you can check out. I also wanna pull out Electro House from the house blanket because what I said about house is that a lot of it has to do with like rhythm and the beat. Electro House does not have that kind of like rhythm or beat. It's very energetic, I guess. Some of these genres are so hard to explain. So let me just show you a few examples. The next major EDM genre on my list is trance music. And again, just like house music, there are so many different types of genres and subgenres under this blanket term of trance music. There's uplifting trance, hard trance, classic trance, acid trance, psytrance. Yeah, the list like goes on and on forever. The types of trance are just so, so different that I'm just gonna play you a few different song examples so you can hear the differences. More melodic side of trance, right? That's generally like the Above and Beyond, Gary Corsten kind of music. Like they can be really uplifting and euphoric and just straight out beautiful. And then of course the other spectrum, like psytrance, hard trance, acid trance, is a lot less like melodic or vocal based. A lot of the times they can be more edgy or like psychedelic sounding. A few very popular trance DJs would be Above and Beyond, Armin van Buuren, Gary Corsten, Simon Patterson, Ace Ventura, Asterix, and Vinny Vici. Obviously, there's a million I can name, but there's just a few for you beginners out there. Here are a few podcasts you can check out. A State of Trance by Armin van Buuren, Group Therapy by Above and Beyond, Corsten's Countdown, and Open Up by Simon Patterson. Open Up is a really cool podcast because Simon Patterson likes to highlight the different styles, and so you get a little bit of each style from the spectrum in his podcast. The next major EDM genre in this video, I'm going to talk about dubstep. I do love dubstep, especially live. Like I just love the bass and I love all the crowd's energy. Of course you have songs and styles that are like more edgy, some that are more melodic, some that are more vocal based. Here are a few song examples and examples I have from live sets of going to different festivals. Some notable dubstep DJs would, of course, be Excision, Virtual Riot, Subtronics, Sudden Death, Blunts and Blondes, Zed's Dead, Zomboy, Ganja White Knight, and Bass Nectar. As far as podcast goes, you can also follow Dead Beats Radio and Zomboy's Rot and Roll Radio. Don't forget to check out some of these DJs' live sets and mixes. Again, the best way you're gonna get exposed to like most of this music. Drum and bass is the next major genre on my list, also referred to as DNB. Like all the other different genres of music, there are subgenres like vocal drum and bass, liquid DNB, jungle, jump up. Drum and bass has a very distinct sound. While it has a very distinct beat, you can't miss it. Here here are some song examples and live examples I took from festivals. You'll hear what I'm saying when I say drum and bass has a very distinct signature. Notable DJs you can check out, really big drum and bass producer DJs in the scene, would be Andy C, Pendulum, Chase and Status, Netsky, Sigma, Noisia, I think, I hope I'm pronouncing it right, Sub Focus, and Camo and Crooked. Actually, now I'm remembering I just said Chase and Status, but when I saw them, the MC actually said Chase and Status, so I think it's actually Chase and Status. I don't know, I'm an American, guys. I probably pronounce stuff wrong all the time. Yeah, you can find really good live sets and mixes from all of these DJs. Netsky is like one of my favorite producer DJs of all time, and he has tons of really good live sets online. Sigma, lots of really good live sets. Trap music is the next major genre I'm gonna mention in this video. The less confusing thing about trap is that there are not a bunch of different subgenres for once, but I do think it's like its own thing. It doesn't necessarily belong under any other major blanket genre terms. So it's getting its own section. Trap music is like basically hip hop, and I know that was a statement that kind of triggered people for a while, but it is generally like hip hop. And I'm gonna play some song examples and you'll hear what I'm talking about. To the next. So trap especially, this section was really hard for me to work on because I don't know or couldn't like narrow down producer DJs that are specifically trap DJs. Like there are a few, but a lot of producer DJs kind of do these like mashups between trap and different genres. Like Slander, Skrillex, Diplo all do make trap music, but for example, like if I send you to their Spotify, the music that comes up right away, like their top 5 or 10 songs, like it may not be trap just because they make so many different genres of music. So it's really hard to pinpoint trap specific DJs. But for the sake of this video, some examples of DJs who make trap are RL Grime, Nightmare, Aerocord, Bauer, Yellowclaw, Flostradamus, and like I mentioned, Slander, Skrillex, and Diplo. Future bass is the next genre in this video, and I am pulling it out as its own genre because I don't think it fits under any of these major genre umbrellas, you know? It doesn't really belong, kind of like trap is its own thing. Future bass, future bass. It has a very distinct sound. Some notable DJs that make future bass would be like Illenium, Seven Lions, San Holo. Slander does make future bass. So like I mentioned, Slander makes trap. They also make future bass and a bunch of different kinds of music. I really love future bass. I've seen all of these DJs a bunch of times. So I'm gonna play some song examples so you can get like a general idea of what future bass sounds like. And then I'll play some live examples that I have from vlogging.
I hope you're good.
The next major blanket genre I'm going to talk about in this video is hardstyle. And actually, the correct term is hard dance music, because hardstyle is a subgenre. Hard dance music is the genre I know most about. It is like my shit. And I don't get like offended because I'm not really like a music snob, and there's no reason to get offended about things that don't matter. But I do kind of cringe when people call everything hardstyle. And that's why I'm doing this video, to inform you guys, not everything is house, not everything is hardstyle, not everything is techno. These are all different genres and subgenres, guys. Euphoric hardstyle relies a lot on melodies, and raw style is a lot more raw and edgy. They're on two completely different sides of the spectrum. And then there's happy hardcore, which is faster than hardstyle, and most of the time it's more melodic. And then there's hardcore, which can be like way more edgy, way more fast, and arguably angry. And so I'm gonna play you some song examples of hardstyle and happy hardcore, and then I have some live examples of different types of hard dance music too. Are a few different producer DJs of hard dance music you can check out. Tatweekas, Atmospheres, Code Black, Rebellion, Malice, Little Texas, Sepha, Angerfist, Aaron Styles is happy hardcore, and he's amazing. I really, really love the Keeping a Rave Alive podcast, because Kutsky's thing is covering 360 degrees of hard dance music, so he features literally all the different styles and flavors of hard dance music. If you want to dive deeper into it, his podcast is definitely the place to start. The last genre I'm going to talk about in this video is techno. I remember a time back in the day when people called everything techno. Everyone just referred to it as techno for some reason. Techno, just like every other genre and subgenre I mentioned in this video so far, is its own thing. It has its very distinct sounds and signatures and styles. Similar to a lot of house, techno is all about the rhythm and the beat, not really about these huge buildups and drops. Like, it's all about taking you on a journey, is the best way I could describe it. And I will play you some clips of some live techno sets I caught recently. Some really notable producer techno DJs out there would be Nicole Madauber, Carl Cox, Richie Houghton, Adam Bayer, Nina Kravitz, Green Velvet, and Charlotte DeWitt. As far as podcasts goes, you can check out Adam Bayer's Drum Code Radio and Chris Leibing's AM/FM. Thank you for tuning into this crash course about the different types of EDM genres. Of course, there are a million, and I absolutely cannot get to them all in this video. I would actually love if everyone out there could help me out and contribute to this video also. Drop your knowledge in the comment section. Feel free to elaborate on the genres I went over briefly in this video. Give some song examples and DJ recommendations. I would appreciate it, and I'm sure everybody else viewing this video will appreciate it too. I hope this video was helpful. I hope I introduced you to a genre maybe you didn't know anything about but you liked. If you're not already subscribed to my channel, I would like to ask you to please do so. It means so much to me. And check out the other EDM and music festival videos on my channel. I spend my life traveling the world for music, and I love sharing my adventures with you guys. Thanks again for watching, and until next time, peace out, Girl Scouts.